Once again, welcome, boys, for this class. During this class, we will again go through some of the main topics, which are rotational types of motion. And for this, we are basically learning different types of the techniques to solve rotational types of the problems. These involve rotational kinetic energy, potential energy, moment of inertia, and angular velocity as well. So angular displacement as well. Show that when the hoop rolls down on an inclined plane, half of kinetic is rotational kinetic energy and half is translation energy. So here it is. Consider a loop of hoop of mass m rolling down on an inclined plane. So v is the angular velocity, v is the linear, and omega is the angular velocity. So now, according to law of conservation of energy, this amount of basically potential energy is equal to loss of potential energy is equal to gain in kinetic energy. So at that time, at height, due to height, its energy was potential energy, which was mgf. When it is rolled down, during rolling and moving straight, it has linear kinetic energy, and due to rotation, it has rotational kinetic energy, and this will be the sum of these two energies together, because this potential energy is converting into translational and rotational as well. Inertia for the hoop formula is mr square. So to calculate angular velocity, formula is v square over r. So after putting all values in this equation of kinetic energy, you are getting this relation. If you look at loss in potential energy, that is equal to 1 over 2 mv square plus half m. After simplification, you look at this r square is cancelled with this one, mv square, 1 over 2 mv square. So if you look at further and simplify it, you shall show that right hand side of the equation 4 shows that the half kinetic energy is translational and half is rotational. So this amount of energy, this portion is for translational, and this portion or the other portion is for rotational. So you have calculated rotational energy. So this clearly shows that half of this energy, potential energy, is converted into translational kinetic energy and half is converted into rotational kinetic energy. So with this, I thank you very much.